the Quran explains what's going to happen to disbelievers if they don't believe, and what's going to happen to believers so long as they believe, right? And if they disbelieve after having believed, then what's going to happen to them? So the Quran is clarifying that there is no choice, there is no other option for humans than to worship God. We are in submission willingly or unwillingly. Maybe we don't realize it. We are bound by the changing of the day and night. Yeah. And even in the Quran, Allah, God, He points to that reality that in the changing of the night and the day, there are signs for those who contemplate. So you cannot cause the sun to rise from the west or moon to disappear, for example. You cannot change your seasons. Your climate is not under your control. You may influence it somewhat, but you cannot change it. You cannot change autumn to something else, right? So you have, what you have to understand is that you are in submission to God. Okay, either you do it willingly and submit entirely, completely, or you are in submission anyway.
That's what Ali said to me. He said, if I don't submit to God, I'll be submitting to something else, like money, power,
yeah,
some other thing.
Yeah, you'll enslave yourself to something else. In life, you'll probably be working for your boss at work. Your entire life will be about that, and that's why people end up getting depressed. They come home, they're not happy. They're not happy. They worked hard for maybe 10 hours a day. They come home, they're depressed. Because they are in submission to the wrong entity. They need to submit to God. Once you submit to God, you could be working 24 hours a day and you'll be happy. That's the phenomenon. What we call itminan al-qalb. In Arabic, it means, it translated into English, it means tranquility of the heart. There are people in Europe, not only in Britain, many people in Europe, they are accepting Islam because their current system is not offering anything to them. Because previously they were completely blind to Islam. They had no idea what Islam is. Now with social media, they are on their phones, they are watching videos, they are reading stuff, and the governments cannot stop that. Yeah. Okay?
I just asked Ali, what's the attraction of Islam? What do you feel Islam gives you?
What is there to offer to him?
Most importantly, a clean life, a cleaner mind, and a cleaner, more rational faith. A way to live, something to live for. Because anything other than Islam fails to provide that. Christianity fails to provide intellectual satisfaction. It doesn't satisfy you.
It's confusing.
It's very confusing. When you read the Bible, you know this is not from God. You know, I mean, any sane person, any honest person, I'm not saying Christians are insane. There are scholars among Christians, right? But sometimes you need to have the sincerity to accept it, right? A lot of these people are not sincere, unfortunately. So you read the Bible with an open mind, you know this is not from God.
Because I've heard Christians say that in the Quran you have the stories of some of the prophets taken from the Bible. And they would say the Quran, they just have shortened versions.
In the Quran we have stories that are similar to the biblical stories. Yeah. They're not the same.
Okay.
They're not borrowed. Because when we look at the details, we come to realize through the Quran, for some reason, somehow corrects the mistakes of the Bible.
And not only that, Ustad, yeah, came to defend one of the prophets. Because if you look into the Bible, it tells you that Lut had intimacy with his own daughters. So the Quran came to defend the honor by rejecting these notions of how the prophets slept.
Yeah, this is the point I was making. Exactly. In the Bible, they say the prophets committed some sins.
Yes, exactly.
Major sins.
Major sins. The Quran came to defend
David.
The honor.
David is getting, you know.
Yeah.
So we don't have that. This is how we know that the Bible has been corrupted. Some corrupt minds, corrupt people inserted their ideas into the Bible. And there is no doubt about that, right? Even Jewish and Christian scholars will admit to that. That there are passages, there are parts of the Bible that have been interpolated, right? So now, what do we do? We have two choices. Either to continue following the way that was given to us, us by our ancestors, or we rethink our existence. We rethink our entire life. Is this the truth? Is this the way to God?